of an old era. Simple. A new beginning is the termination of an old era. A new beginning is suspension of anything that is archaic in your life, especially the one that you don't want. In the book of Genesis chapter 8, 18 and 19, Genesis 8, 18 and 19, you will see that Noah and his children and his family, nuclear family to say, a little addition to them, they were in the ark and some animals. Two of all clean animals. They were in the ark of Noah. And it was getting frustrating. Because for you to be in a place, when they put people in the house by arrest, even if there is TV, you'll be tired. You'll be, if you stay in the house for 1 month, you'll be tired. They did not put any chain in your hand. That is why whenever they put some people, big men, big women, under house arrest, their health will start feeling them. They are not beating them more. Because you are not meant to be stagnant, whether in physical movement or even in achievement. And whenever there is stagnation in any area of your life, you start feeling frustrated inside there. And there are so many silent frustrations in life. Silent people are not saying it, but internally they are tired of being tired. At this particular time, they are being in the ark. When will the water abate and we will come out of this ark? Even though that ark was once upon a time a protection to them, but after a while it will get, they were tired of it. And you can imagine all the animals, whenever they want to poop, they poop inside. If they want to, you know, it's when you think deep, you will not understand the kind of frustration that was not coming to Noah. Sending the bed, go and see, so that whether we can go out. Go and see, that one will have no place to land and will come back. And when will this thing end, that will come out, that will be free? When will we have this new beginning? And Noah went forth, and his sons, and his wives, and his wife, and his sons' wives, within every beast, every creeping thing, and every fowl, and whatsoever creepeth upon the earth after their kind, went forth out of the ark. There are many of us that we have been in some forms of ark in our life. This month, we are going out. Yeah. This month, a new beginning is starting in your life. Yeah. I want to tell you that those kind of arcs that many people are in, they are not ordinary arcs. They are being shot by powers beyond physical sight. That's why the Bible says that in the book of Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12, Ephesians 6, 12, says that we wrestle not against what? Flesh and blood, but against principalities, against power, against rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Those are the forces that we are wrestling against. And they keep those doors of the ark of people shut so that they will not step out to experience the new. But God has already said that we are going to be experiencing the new. Hence, we must deal with anti-new beginning powers this morning. Very early, we must deal with it. In the book of Psalm 101, I think it should be Psalm 101 verse 8. Psalm 101 verse 8. That David said that very early will he destroy all the wicked forces in the land. Why? So that he will enjoy the remaining part of his life. I will early destroy all the wicked of the land, that I may cut off the wicked doers from the city of the Lord. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, every power that has shut me in to any old unpleasant experience, let that power expire now. Open your mouth and pray. Every power that has shut me in to any unpleasant old experience, expire. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. So shall it be for you in the name of Jesus.
their powers
in this life. In the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 16 verse 9, 1 Corinthians 16 9, Apostle Paul, the great bishop, he said that there are so many doors, great door, effectual door has been opened unto him, but there are many what? Enemies. 1 Corinthians 16 9, for a great door, an effectual, is opened unto me. And what?
There are many
enemies. Enemies for progress. God has opened door for somebody to receive maybe visa, or somebody to receive a spouse, or a child, or whatever that thing, or a good job, or an accommodation. But the Bible said that there are many adversaries. Apostle Paul, somebody that has deep spiritual understanding, there are many enemies they are standing. Even David said it in the book of Psalm 24, 7 to 10. Psalm 24, 7 to 10. Then I lift up your head, O ye what?
Yes.
And be lifted up, ye everlasting door, that the King of glory will come in. And you will now see a satanic response. Who is that King of glory that we should lift up the door? Lift up your head, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. Now, lift up your head, O ye gates. Even lift them up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who are these people that are challenging this? They are forces from hell. Who is this King of glory that we should lift up and we should allow this lady to go? That we should allow this man to be settled? Who is this King of glory? Then they now responded, the Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. Say that. The Lord of hosts means that Lord that is mighty in battle and he has battalions. They surrender. The enemy will surrender.
Yeah.
In your life, the enemy will surrender.
Yeah.
Anything expedient that you rise to pray whenever there is a new beginning call, there are forces that will want to prevent that. That's why this morning, God has just ministered to us that we should go in the way of deliverance. Many people have been kept into experiencing the old because of forces of darkness, and they will die.
Amen.
Because until some things die or some people die, some people will not progress. Isaiah chapter 6 verse 1. Isaiah 6 1. Bible said that in the year King Isaiah died, that was when he was able to see the glory that God has planned for him. He had been dreaming that it would be very great. Or he will be seeing contract, seeing everything, but near sunset, near, but anybody that was that, for you to be settled this month, will die.
Amen.
In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw also the Lord sitting upon a throne, high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. Meaning, this King Uzziah, who happened to be his uncle, an entering force. I was talking to one brother in America. You know, we were calling. We called and he, I think about 2 years ago, I was telling him, we were just Jesus, he said that Nigeria, Nigeria, further than thy prayer. It's too much. Life is not like that. It's not as terrible. How can you be here? I said, yeah, because Kuya is blowing you. I said the fact that Kulia is blowing, just like we're telling the people doing any favor. I said there is nowhere that demons are not in. Nowhere. Nigerian demons. They are different. I think they have not gotten to the kind of demon that some nations are. The demon that children will carry gun. I will go to the class. I will start shooting. It's demon manifestation.
Yes, yes.
Demonic manifestation. I will thank God that the kind of disaster that we hear, that we carry out this takes away what people have worked and they have retired and carry it away. Thank God it's not. I just said that, don't fool yourself. There is nowhere that there are no negative power, but there are manifestation in this guy, in this ways. I will not tell him that. Well, in as much as I don't believe in the extreme of such prayer, there is not every time that people gather in church, fall and die. I don't believe in that. It's true. There should be teaching, there should be everything balanced. But saying those kind of prayer is not needed is fooling yourself. Because some people must die. It's not the truth. I said that will you be holier than God that took him so? Go and kill all these people. And you spared one. I said, because you spared one, I terminated my plan for you. Are you wiser than that God? He said that you people, they just be saying, they are not killing people. I said, maybe it's prayer that they are using. Who is answering that prayer? I said, who is answering the prayer? I said, if they are praying amiss, God reserved the right not to answer it. Meaning that there are some situations that that prayer is very necessary. Very important. And every power that is not allowing you to see a glorious season in your life, that power with that.
Amen.
And the people cooperating with that power with that.
Amen.
One woman lost her husband. And she now went to a church, stay in a sorrowful mood after so many months. Because it really shook her. And she prayed with them in that church. She had never really gone to pray in church like that. She just prayed very well. She prayed that her blouse got soaked of her sweat. By the time she got to her housemaid of about 15 years, told her, congratulations, you have just started praying. She was first shocked at the oil factory. And that because she had never seen her like that before. So what do you mean? How can you be talking to me like that? And it's the prayer that is manifesting in her life. He said, well, in case you don't know, I kill your husband. She was just shocked. Then, you know, she was afraid, but also bold. Afraid of said that, well, you cannot stay with me in this house. You are going. He said, no problem, I will go. But let me tell you, I have initiated three of your daughters. She has been living with this lady for 15 years. Rise up to your feet and pray and say, Father, any power that has been preventing my new beginning, eradicate now, eradicate that power. Expose and eradicate from my life. Or your place of work, or your neighborhood, or anywhere at all, let the fire of God locate them. Eradicate them from your life. And let your new beginning start now. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. God bless you, well, please be seated. So it's very important that you pray so that you can enter into your new season. Or else the story will be the same. We don't want old story. But our God is a fighter. He will fight for us.
Amen.
So don't be saying that those kind of prayer, don't join them to be saying that there are some prayer that it's the devil that is trying to strike them so that you will be having a field day in their life. Because it's the prayer fire that will drive him out. Just like when fire enter into the stick. The viper just came out. The viper has been there. And I had eaten among the stick when Paul was trying to cool himself. Very important. David used to pray some prayers like that. And God called him a man after man in Psalm 10 verse 15. Funny prayers. But it could be funny to human understanding. But God understood what he was trying to say. And God was answering. Psalm 10 verse 15. He said God should break somebody's teeth. Bring down the arm of the wicked and the evil man. Seek out the wickedness till thou find none. When you read the book of Psalm 144, verse 6, David will always pray against the wicked in his life. Cast forth lightning, scatter them, shoot out their arrows. And what? And it's not, it is not out of place in some people's consideration. In the book of Psalm 118, 10 to 12, Psalm 118, he said, we destroy them in the name of the Lord. He said, let them gather against him, he will destroy them. He is talking about destruction. Meaning that there are some things that you should destroy. All nations compass me about, but in the name of the Lord, I will destroy them. They compass me about, but in the name of the Lord, I will destroy them. 12. They compass me about like bees, meaning that they are so much and they can sting. They are quenched as the fire of dawn, for in the name of the Lord, I will destroy them. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, in the name of Jesus, let every opposition in my life be destroyed. In the similitude of this scripture, every opposition to my progress, to my settlement, to my forward movement, for my fruitfulness, to my joy, to my peace, to my well-being, to my good health, every opposition, whether I'm aware of it or not, destroy. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Let every opposition in your life, opposition to your good life, be destroyed. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. So we don't just have the anointing to bless. We have the anointing to destroy. It's good to bless, but sometimes you have to arise and destroy. Now that for this purpose, 1 John chapter 3, verse 8. For this purpose, the Son of God was made manifest to destroy the work of darkness. So that is one of the reasons Jesus Christ came. 1 John 3, 8. He that committed sin is of the devil, for the devil sinned from the beginning. For this purpose, the Son of God was manifested. Destroy the works of the devil. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, every work of the devil in my life and my family, destroy every work of the devil in my life and in my family. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. So shall it be in Jesus' name. So don't believe that those kind of prayers, they are out of place. It's not that you should be too extreme, as some people are extreme. Every time, follow down. But there are some times you must arise and decrease such prayers. In the book of Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 10, God himself told Jeremiah, I have commissioned you, I have anointed you, not just to plant and to build, but also to destroy. See, I have this day set thee over the nations and over the kingdom to do what? To root out number one, and to pull down number two, and to destroy number three, and to throw down number four, before they now talk about two things safe. To build and to plant. Keep on building and planting, the enemy will be destroying. Many people, they have done so well in the time back, but the enemy has brought them down. Because they did not take time to do the first thing. First thing first, destruction of any evil around you. Then whatever you build will not stay. That's the wisdom of this scripture. He said that I have anointed you to do these things first. Then by the time you build, no more contention. I prophesy into your life. Every power that has been pulling down all the things that you have been building, your career, building your family, building your head, let those powers disappear. Yeah. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. So for you to expect a new beginning, you
must rise to pray.
And in family of four, five boys, and all of them got married, the first four got married. No issue. From the first born to the fourth. And the fifth one, by the time he was to get married, you know, he now got born again. He started attending church. He now got a prayer book. He was just praying, everything inside that prayer book. And the Lord now ministered to him that when he will get married, he should not sleep with his wife for 7 days. I actually told the fiance that time that this is what I was ministered to. Now I said, no problem. So they got married on the first night, nothing. On the second night, the wife that started coming here, he said, I remember what he said. You know, on the third night, it was war between them. Because he said, I will do it. But on the fourth night, and he said, no. This is what God has said. You know, I saw this vision very clearly. You know, I'm not someone that normally see vision. But this one, I saw it. Then I started praying. Let's hack into it. On the third night, it was like, well, they even had issues. Then the fourth day, they received a call from home that the mother was calling them. By the time they got to the mother was saying that they should forgive her. Forgive you for what? They did not know that it happened to be in one occult. That the male seed, the first male seed of the marriage, she would take it from them and use it to fortify herself in that court, and those ones will be childless. But because the first three they and they have given her the deadline of 3 days in their marriage, we will bring it. So she could not succeed. That was the fourth day. That was why the third day was war between them, because there were forces that were trying to get them to meet so that she can collect it. How she will come in the name of the Spirit to do it, I don't know. But by the time she confessed, she died. Anyone in your life, in your family, that has been beyond anything that you are not settled with, let the power of God kill them. And let whatever they have prevented you from getting, this month you will get. Of witches and wizards
to hinder your progress, to hinder your well-being. Let the fire of God from heaven fall and destroy them. Anywhere they have tied your progress, in any coven, in any forest, let the thunder of God visit that place and set your progress free. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
Very important that you arise so that your new beginning will start.
The story of five sisters too. All of them married. But the same thing, every one of them packed back to their parents, their grandparents. Because their own parents were also living in their grandparents' house. One of them, sister number 1, 2, 3, 4 to 5. The last boy also stumbled on one prayer book. And because she was tired, why is everybody like this? But she was just, you know, everybody, the other people did not see that way. But she started seeing that way. And she prayed that prayer one night, 12 to 1. She woke up. Pray all the prayer inside some of the prayer points she did not even understand. She was just praying anyhow. Then when money came, the grandmother came to her in the room, said that, hey, you were praying yesterday. Don't That was not the kind of prayer that we brought you up with. You don't pray like that. Pray the kind of prayer. I don't know the kind of church they give. We are not that kind of prayer. Don't pray like that. Say, okay, grandma. Okay. But we did not say that. Me that I was not shouting. How did she know that I was praying like that? Say, ah. She now said, okay. The next day, she will take it to extra hour. She now did the thing and got to almost half of the book. She said, very early, the grandmother came. You want to kill somebody with your prayer? People is praying that kind of easy, devilish prayer that you are praying. Yeah, man, okay, my man. The third day, she went to 4 a.m. By the time people got up, grandma died. I prophesied to her, every king Uzziah. There's something I will quickly tell you before the time runs out. So many things to say, but no time. One thing that can frustrate your effort in trying to have a new beginning is if you are not competing with God. Because can two work together? They must retreat, except they be agreed. And if you are not in agreement with God, indirectly, you are competing with the devil. The Bible said that shall we continue in sin, Romans 6, 1 and 2, that the grace of God be abound? God forbid. Isaiah chapter 59, 1 and 2, Isaiah 59, 1 and 2. The Bible said that the hand of the Lord is not short. It's very strong and very long hand. But sometimes we appear shorting. And his ears are no one deaf. He that created ears, we did not hear. But not hearing some people's prayer because they are doing things contrary to his will. Proverbs chapter 15 verse 8. Proverbs 15:8. The Bible said that the sacrifice of the wicked, who is a sinner, is an abomination to the Lord. But the prayer of the upright is delight. Don't use your own hand to be spoiling your own life. Are you living in sin or you are harboring sinful habits? The devil wants you to keep it in secret because darkness prevails in secrecy. That is why it's in the night that dark things normally happen. Dark things in the spiritual in the night. Even when people want to steal, when they want to do something in that, anything about darkness is being covered. He also wants you to cover it. But once you can bring it to the light, the devil has lost in your life. Proverbs chapter 28, verse 13. Proverbs 28:30. Verse that whosoever covereth his sin shall not prosper. But anybody that confesses and forsakes that sin, you have mercy. If that covereth his sins shall not prosper. This is the word of God. But whoso confesseth and forsaketh them shall have mercy. And mercy is what anybody needs to prevail in life. Mercy. Mercy. Romans chapter 9 verse 16. Romans 9 16. It's not of he that willeth, no he that runneth, but it's God that showeth mercy. Once God can show you mercy, it does not matter the number of times that you have done anything wrong, it's clear the way. It does not matter the gravity of what you have done, it's clear the way. The blood of Jesus Christ cleanses us from all unrighteousness. Shall we bow our head? Let's bow our head. If you are here, you know that you are struggling with one sinful habit or one sinful lifetime. Congratulations. This July, Thanksgiving, is your freedom day so that you can start a new day. You may not have the power to stop it, but God has the power. But he wants you to acknowledge and confess. That is your own part. Once you do your part, you do his part. Wherever you are, you want me to pray for you under this unction. Lift up your right hand. God bless you. Lift up your right hand. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God is part of you because you are not ashamed of him. And you are not hiding or covering your sin. God bless you. 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 All the people that have received the card and are lifting their hand, can you just repeat after me? Say, my heavenly Father, thank you for your word that has come. I am sorry for all the wrongs I have done. Please forgive me. Cleanse me with the blood of Jesus. Make me whole, make me holy. Help me to stand where I have been falling. Surround me with positive influences that will shield me from negative ones. Let my name be written afresh in your book of life and ensure it is not removed again till I see you in glory. Thank you for hearing my prayers. In Jesus' mighty name, I have prayed. Amen. Let me pray for you. Father, thank you for this, your children that have made this confession. Back up their confession with your power. Just as they have said, because it is written in your word, and they have spoken in my ears, so will I do. Please be for them. Help them not to go back to anything they are not proud of that have made them to do the confession. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. God bless you. Please feed those cards and return to the ushers after the service so that we'll keep on praying for you on that note. And God will sustain you. Shall we rise to our feet? Let's rise to our feet. I want you to open your mouth and pray and say, Father, clear the way, clear all powers against my new beginning.